Life can get hectic at holiday time in three main areas: spending, eating, and clutter, which is related to homekeeping. So in this video, I'm going to give you three tips on how to get your house back under control after the chaos of the holidays. Tip number one is to do the dishes. To get your house back in shape, just do the dishes. Clean your kitchen and just have that one little area of calm, of clean. It'll give you such a feeling of control. So start there. Get back on your routines, but just start where you are. Morning routines, daily routines, weekly routines. Just start where you are. Don't try to catch up. Just start where you are. Whatever it is that you usually do to maintain your house on a day-to-day basis, do that. Don't worry about the zones right now. You just want to do the basic necessities. Next, put away holiday clutter. That means take down your holiday decor, pack it up, and get the bins put away. Then put away your Christmas gifts. That just helps to reduce the visual clutter. I used to let Christmas gifts sit on my counter or my dresser for several days, sometimes even weeks after Christmas. I just liked looking at them, but it does add to the visual clutter. So get your Christmas decor packed up and the bins put away, and get those Christmas gifts put away. Find a place for them and get them put away. And something else that's really important but quite simple is to get out your planner. Get your planner out and decide what it is that you need to take care of today, tomorrow, this week, and next week, and put it in your planner. Make your plan and then work the plan. And once you make that plan, make a to-do list, and then as you accomplish your tasks, mark them off. There is such a feeling of accomplishment when you get those tasks marked off. So make a plan, work the plan, and slowly but surely, your house will get back under control. Tip number two is to review your budget. Holiday time brings a lot of extra expenses, what with the possibility of travel for many of you, extra holiday grocery shopping for the different foods and desserts and things you like to prepare at holiday time, and then gift giving. The floodgates have been open with all the buying for gifts, and then the shopping, shopping, shopping. So it's really easy to get caught up in that cycle and just keep on shopping. So the first thing you want to do is sit down and review your budget. So get out your bank statements, get out those credit card bills, and I know you probably don't want to take a look at them, but it's going to be important to get those credit card bills out and then take a look at how much damage you've actually done. It may not be as bad as you think, or it could be. But regardless, what you want to do is assess the damage, see what's what, and then make a plan to handle it. So you might need to create a new budget for the family, or you might need to reset a budget that you've already got in place. But regardless, you want to make sure that you create or set a new budget and then go according to plan. Another thing you can do is to give yourself a no spend or a low spend challenge. For example, I'm going to join Kate Caton in her January no spend. And when you're doing a no spend or even a low spend, you get to decide what the rules are. For me and my family, we are going to do a no spend January, which will include no grocery shopping for other than produce and dairy. That means I'm going to be shopping from my fridge, my freezer, and my pantry. Other than that, there will be no spending unless it's absolutely necessary, and that includes eating out. I'm going to limit our eating out to only twice in the 30-day period. I can decide what happens in February, but for January, I am cutting way back. This is a good time to say that this video is part of the Mega Motivation Collaboration for 2022, and it is hosted by me, This and That with Denise Jordan, and Robyn at the Minimalist Home. And we have invited quite a few YouTube creators to join us in bringing to you tips on how to get back on track after the chaos of the holidays. There will be a playlist, which I will link in the description box below, so that you can check out all the videos that the other creators have put together to help you get back on track after the chaos of the holidays. Be sure to check them out. And this video is brought to you by aprondiva, my online apron boutique. Pretty and practical, we believe that an apron can be a homemaker's best accessory. Visit us at www.aprondiva.com. Tip number three is to make a meal plan. Now, one of the things that happens so often at holiday time, at least for me and many that I know, is that we tend to overeat. There's just so many goodies and so many foods that maybe we only get at certain times of the year that we overindulge. So to get back on track with your eating is to create a meal plan. And you can create that meal plan in your planner. Most of today's planners have a space for you to put your meal plan in. However, if the planner that you're using doesn't have that, then you can create a meal plan on a piece of notebook paper, or you can find an online template that you can get access to for free. But create a meal plan so that you know what you're going to be having for at least your dinners, if not all three meals each day. And then work the plan. Another thing you can do is to drink more water. And drinking more water will help to fill you up. So if you're used to feeling pretty full from eating all the goodies from the holiday season, drinking additional water will give you that sense of fullness. And the nice thing about the water is that it's calorie free. You may also be craving sweets. You might have overindulged on the different delicious desserts that your family has for the holiday season, and now you're continuing to crave sweets. Well, you can try to fill that craving with fresh fruits, apples, oranges, peaches, whatever fresh fruits that you like. You can try to replace those sweets of the holiday with fresh fruits. Or if you feel like you absolutely must have something because you really don't want to try to quit cold turkey, is you want a slice of pie, then give yourself a half a slice of pie. Start looking at your portion sizes and things like that and gradually cut back. Another thing you can do is to eat your meals at home, because you're more in control when you eat your meals at home. When you go out to a restaurant or to someone else's home, there's so many temptations that can kind of get you off track. So if you eat your meals at home, you're more in control and less tempted. When you go grocery shopping, shop with a list. If it's not on the list, don't buy it. And probably the most important thing for you to think about is to give yourself grace. Don't beat yourself up for whatever discretions, or shall I say indiscretions, you might have done over the holiday season. If your house is out of control, make a plan on how you're going to get it back in control. If you overate, then make a meal plan so that you can get your eating back in line. And if you broke the bank, you broke the budget, then sit down with your partner, get out your bank statements, and make a plan as to how you can get back on track. It may take you a few months to do it, but it's certainly doable. What do you need to reset after the holidays? Is your house at sixes and sevens? Did you break the bank with holiday spending, or is it your eating that's out of control? Tell me in the comment section, and then tell me which of my tips you're going to employ to get yourself back on track. If you got value out of this video, hit the like button. For more homemaking and homekeeping stories, click here. In the meantime, this is Denise Jordan saying, you are not done yet. Click on the link in the comment section below for more homekeeping inspiration, and I will see you next time. And don't forget to visit us at www.aprondiva.com.